Hi. I would like to make a little app with my character Pinky. I've made a little walk cycle here. So I press the button, the left button, and if I press the middle button here, Pinky is picking up stuff from the ground, and if I pick the last button here, Pinky is trying to jump into the air to avoid some obstacles or something. So my idea is to make some kind of little game where Pinky is picking up some kind of corn or seeds and walking in this ice landscape here. So, but for now I'll try to make show you how I made the animations in Thunkable. Let's get started. So I've made a new app in Thunkable here, and I have uploaded my images with my walk cycle and my jump cycle and my pick frame here, and I also have a title and my UI stuff. And in the blog editor, I've put in the names of the frames, so we are ready to go. The first thing I'll do is to drag in a canvas and set it to width fill parent, height fill parent, and width fill parent here, so we have a full screen game playing here. I set the background color to blue. And yeah, that's it. So in my game window here, I will have a title. So I'll use an image sprite here, and I set the position to 0 by 0 here, and I choose my title image here. And I set the width and the height. Like that, and then I need my Pinky sprite, so I put him in the center here. I pick the first walk frame here. So, and then I need my three buttons, which also is image sprites. And I set those to 72 pixels. Like that. And I just pause and put in the two. So I have put in my three buttons here, and I renamed my image sprites to title, pinky, left button, up button, and down button. Then I need two clocks to change the images, and one clock to position my layout after 1 second. So this clock 2 I'll use to position the layout, and the clock 1 I'll use to animate my sprite. So I set the interval in milliseconds to 200, and I disable the timer on clock 1 And clock 2, I have the timer enabled and set the interval to 1000, meaning that after 1 second, our UI will be adjusted. And I found out that's necessary to position if you place your UI according to the size of the canvas. So you have to wait a second or to be able to measure the right size of the UI. Here in the block editor, I will start by initializing some global variables. So the first we need is some image lists. So I have an image list walk. And I have an image list jump. And finally, I'll make an image list called pick, like that. And we initialize them as empty lists. And then in our initialize, we'll define the content of the list. So I also need another list called current list to change between the different animations, and I finally need an index variable to control the frame we're in. So I call that image index. And I set it to our start index, which is 1. So when the screen initializes, I would like to put content in my lists. Oh, that was the wrong one. So here I'll put in a list. And this one, I need 3 items. So this is my walk animation. And I copy this and I pick my jump. And I'll just take my jump frames here. That. And then I'll make my pick list here. And I only need 2 in this one. So I'll take the pinky pick and then I'll take the third pinky walk, because that's where he looks like this. So I'll have these 2 frames here when he picked something up. Okay, and then I would like to set up my clock, what to happen in those. So I'll actually start with my clock 2. Which was the one I used to place my sprites on the canvas so they will be positioned correctly. So I'll make a procedure called place sprites. And I call that when clock 2 fires, and then I'll disable clock two. I only need this to happen once. So I set the clock two, timer enabled to false. And this one I put in the layouts of our sprites. So the thing is, I want to place it so it's responsive. So if you play your game on a small screen versus a big screen, the sprites will be placed in the same spot on the screen. So the first thing is that I'll set pinky x value to the center of screen. And I'll calculate that by subtracting the size of our sprite and the size of our canvas. So I pick the width of our canvas here. And I divide that in two. Through here, and then I subtract the width of our pinky sprite. So we find the middle of the canvas, and then I subtract the half of our sprite, and we have it placed nice in the center. And then I also need to set the Y position of Pinky. And here I can use the same here. I only need the height of our canvas and the height of our sprite. Like that. Then I need to set the height or the position of our title. And I'll place it also in the center. So I'll pick the title here, and I set the Y to just to 20. Like that. Then I need to place my three buttons. So I'll set the X value to 20. And the Y value, set that to canvas height minus. So I take the canvas height and I subtract the height of the button. Plus 20. So it should be placed 20 pixels from the bottom of our canvas. And then I set the down button that I have to set in the center of the screen, so I can use this. And I pick the down button here, like that. And the Y is actually the same as this one. And then I need the up button. And that I have to place from the right edge. So I can use this one and set it to width, and down, up button, width, plus 20. So it'll be 20 pixels from the right edge. And then I set the Y. And that has to be the height minus the height plus 20. So this should place our UI in a nice setup. Then I need to define what should happen when the clock 1 timer fires. And I'll use that to change the image on our sprite. So I'll first check on our index. If our index, image index, is greater than the length of our current lists, then set the index to 1. And then we would like to set the image of our sprite to the index of the item in our current list, and our image index. And then I finally increment my Image index was one. So in this manner, we will have a little an animation that runs 200,000 times in a second. That's around 20. I can't. What's that? That's if it was 100, it was 10 times in a second. So I think it's 5 times in a second. Five frames in a second. So the animation is quite slow, but you can put in more frames if you like. So we need to set up the events for our buttons. So I start with my lift button, and when it's down, touchdown, I would like to set the current lists to the image list walk. And I enable the clock one to have the animation run. And when we release our button on touch up, I like to stop the clock again. And I would like to call a reset. So I'll make a procedure here called reset. Oh. And in this one, I will set the picture of Pingu to the first image in our walk list. And I call that procedure here as well. And then I can just duplicate these two and change the names of the buttons here. Like that. So when I press the down button, I pick set the current list to on my pick animations, and when I press the up button, I change the current list to my jump animation. And for each up and down button, when touch up, I'll disable the timer. So we stop the animation, and I reset the sprite to set the picture to the first frame of our walk, and which is this one. So now let's see if it runs. So I'll reset the current connection, and I'll start a new connection. And here we are in the mirror of my screen, my my phone screen, and as you can see, the UI has rearranged. So I try to press the left button here, and you can see Pinky is walking, and I press the middle button, and he is picking something up from the ground, and the final button here. Oh, Pinky is jumping! So that's going to be an awesome game. This is a start, so the next thing will be to make a scrolling background so we can have a scene to walk in, and then I'll put in some items to pick up. So, thank you for watching. Bye.